Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. The prosecution wrapped up this morning for a third day of testimony from Kat McDonough in the murder trial of Seth Mazzaglia. Striking last words from Kat McDonough.
Who strangled Lizzie Marriott to death?
Seth did.
Now the defense has taken over. We do want to warn you, some of her testimony was graphic. Ray Brewer has more on how the defense started their cross-examination.
Defense attorney Joachim Barth began by asking Kat McDonough about a meeting at his office 2 days after Seth Mazzaglia was arrested for the murder of Lizzie Marriott. Barth said at that meeting, McDonough told a very different tale of how Marriott died.
You sat down and told us that Liz Marriott died while you were having sex with her, correct?
That's what I told you.
Barth said after that meeting, McDonough would change her story and suggested a reason for the change.
You were actively engaged in attempting to avoid any other charges based on your actions, correct?
Yes.
Barth also questioned McDonough about several different names she used to describe herself and multiple personalities she'd adopted.
In addition to Scarlet, you went by Violet at times.
Yes.
You went by Anae.
Yes.
Sometimes James was present, correct?
The defense also asked McDonough about claims of past lives and if she and Seth had met together in the past. During the cross-examination, there have been numerous objections by the prosecution claiming that much of what the defense is asking is hearsay. Remember, you can watch the trial as it continues today live here on our website, WMUR.com. Well, police this afternoon want to know who called in a bomb threat to the CVS on Hooksett Road in Hooksett. Last night, the store was evacuated and area roads were closed until the State Police Bomb Squad determined there were no explosives. That store reopened a short time later. So far, no arrests have been made. A Hudson man arrested for DWI in Nashua is now facing additional charges. Police say Nathaniel Rhines tampered with a sprinkler in his cell, causing it to flood. When officers tried to get him out, they say he punched a jail employee twice, ripping his clothes, and then tried to bite both him and an officer. Bedford police need your help finding a missing resident there. 82-year-old Beverly Archambault was last seen yesterday morning. She is believed to be driving a 2006 green Toyota Corolla. Police say they are concerned because there may be some developing memory problems. Anyone who has seen Beverly or knows where she is urged to call police. Starting tonight at 5, the movie Frozen has created a boost for another industry. Who says the film is directly responsible for a 30% increase in business? And what men need from their diet changes as they grow older. How to know what your guys should be eating at each stage of life. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.